not true. But how is it helpful?
Chris, hold on. First of all, what is wrong with calling anyone a Muslim? Because I don't think there's anything wrong with
it. It is, and when also they're not.
It was.
I'll call you a Muslim.
Mistake to actually.
It's not accurate.
Yeah,
right?
That's fine. But it's fine. What I'm saying is, you can call me a Muslim if you want, but I'm not going to take it. I'm not going to use it against you or against me in this case, because that's what I said. That was my opinion. But let's talk about now. Let's talk about today. What's going on right now in Los Angeles and California?
During the convention,
we have $26 billion in immigration.
I get it, but if you want to represent a group of people, let alone a district that Clinton won by 22 points,
I'm representing the American people. Listen.
But who are you representing by calling Obama a Muslim when you know it's not
true?
What is that supposed to do?
But right now, I'm not talking about that. You're bringing that up.
Well, it's too bad. You said it before. You got to own it now if you want to be in office.
Chris, nobody's perfect, and I'm willing to express my opinions and also my mistakes.
So will you apologize?
I should have responded that way. I did. I also did on The View, if you remember, if you did your homework. But obviously you did.
No, I don't remember you saying. I remember you saying in the transcript, he's probably not a Muslim. I understand that. That's not really an apology, right? Because you knew he wasn't a Muslim when you said it.
Well, if there's nothing wrong with calling him a Muslim, I shouldn't apologize.
It is a false allegation done to disparage him and
Chris,
to fear hate
Chris,
in, to feed
Chris,
hate jur- in people.
Journalism, Chris, journalism is dead. You should be asking questions as a journalist in the middle. I'm a Republican, but the way you guys attack
Why
do you take sides?
How is the side is
understand.
Truth? Why did you say
How
this?
Do you take sides?
What did you mean? It's not
it's amazing.
True.
Well, the American people know what's going on. And you know what? They know what's going on. And this November, they will know even more because they will get people in Congress who are there who love this country. And there's one thing you can say whatever you want about me, but I love this nation and I care. I care about my community. I care about my people. I listen to what they want and I'm going to do exactly what they want me to do, not what
do
I
want
to do.
They
what
want
my
you,
community wants to do.
Do you think they want you to divide people along Christian and Muslim lines?
They want.
And say that people
no,
should
I would
be
never
in
do
jail
that. Chris,
if you don't agree
change,
with their
don't,
politics?
Listen. Listen, don't change the narrative and make it work for you, because that's what you guys do best. American people are a lot smarter than you. That's why they don't watch your network. I'm here to promote something for the American people.
So you came on a network that nobody watches? Why did you do that?
Yeah, not a
problem. You're the smart guy.
Because I wanted to talk to you. I really did. I'm not scared of you guys.
I want to have this conversation.
I'm not afraid of you guys whatsoever.
You shouldn't be afraid of the truth and coming on to have a real debate about ideas.
You attack people. You attack people. And the way you attack this administration and anybody who's involved with them is disgraceful. And you should actually go to communion or whatever you want to do and just kind of make peace with the men upstairs, because you guys
wouldn't go to communion. You would go to penance. Are you a Catholic?
You go to penance.
All right. Well, you got to check your catechism, my brother. If you're going to use it against somebody else, know what you're talking about first, all right? If you're going to throw big bombs, make sure you know where they landed.
That's right. Well, that's something you should do, because you're doing a lot more than I do.
I'm helping you out here, but I understand your own faith.
People.
Let me ask you something else about immigration.
I don't need your help,
you need a little
Mr.
bit
Cuomo.
Of help.
I don't.
A little bit of help right
yeah,
now
I don't.
You need.
Not from you.
On
never.
Immigration.
I will never take any help from you.
Well, look, I'm giving you an opportunity
legally.
To address the audience. You came. You're from Italy. You were born there. You came legally.
I was born there.
The problem with
legally.
The country's immigration
Correct.
System is twofold. You have a legal immigration issue and an illegal immigration issue. Do you agree with
you
President Trump about a zero tolerance approach to illegal immigration?
You know, when I came here in 1985 and we waited in line for many years, and my parents actually ran out of money because we came here for 2 years on a green card and we have to go back to Italy. But the first time we came here, we worked hard. And when we came to the border, we had to sign a paper that said, no, don't take any welfare from this country. That was the good old days. Now, when you come here illegally or whatever, you come in here and you get free programs the American people have to pay for. That's wrong. And I think we should take care of the American people.
What if people need help when they get here to get a leg up? What if they need help?
What about the American people? What about the American
people?
Well,
those
do it legally. I'm saying we have a door.
American people too.
Chris, you know what? They don't even have to leave their country. They can go to the embassy, the United States embassy, and ask for asylum right there. They don't even have to cross the border. But you know and I know that they're coming here illegally because it's human trafficking. They're bringing drugs to this country, and they're bringing it back to their place. So this has been going on for way too long.
Agreed. But, you know, I think the some matters, right? The context matters. Zero
some
tolerance
matters.
Means
yes,
nobody gets in. Do you agree with the president that border agents should be able to turn everybody back without due process?
Listen, there's a lot of people in Europe, right? Millions of people that are waiting to come here. All over the world, they want to come here. I get it. I did it the right way. But we have to follow the law. And we have a great law.
Right, so I'm saying, do you agree?
If you follow them, Zero tolerance? Come through the door. If I came to your house and I went through the window instead of the door or knocked at the door with all my kids and everybody else and used your house and ate at your dinner table and everything like this, would you call
the
police?
What if you climbed through the window of my house because somebody was chasing you with an axe?
I wouldn't do that. I would call the police. I would do it
some other
way.
What if you don't have time to call the police? There's somebody chasing you with an axe and my window is open. Would you jump in?
No, actually, I would take the guy with the axe out, and then I would take care of myself. I wouldn't use your house.
Well, what if everybody's not as tough as you, and they can't take out a guy with an axe?
No, it's not tough.
You understand what I'm saying, right? What I'm saying is not every situation is equal, but I want to get some questions from you on the record. Do you agree with not needing due process before border agents send people back?
I think if you cross the border, like I repeated myself already, if you cross the border illegally, there's a price you got to pay. I think if you do it legally through the door, come in legally, then we are allowing you to be an American citizen at some point. Just do it legally. That's all I'm saying.
So legal immigration coming through, what the numbers are, that's one issue. Illegal is another one. We just had this flashpoint with the separation of kids from their parents as they come across and the mess that has resulted that's going on right now. Do you agree with
it's
what
awful.
The president did there?
Well, actually, he overridden that because he wants families to stay together with their kids. This was started by Obama administration because
it was not
and I can't blame
it
for that because kids were coming here, you know, human trafficking and carrying drugs themselves. Listen, we have a border. If we don't have a border, we don't have a country.
Right,
I agree
but what
with
do you
that.
Do with the kids? Do you separate them from the parents or you keep them together?
No, absolutely not. I would never separate. Don't ask me that question. I have kids of my own. I know you're trying to be a smartass, but listen, I would never allow kids
the
or parents to be separated.
The president just separated kids from families. I asked you if you endorsed it. You went another direction. Now you don't like the question. Do you think he did the right thing or the wrong thing?
Yeah, that's CNN talking. I don't think the president said that at all, so I disagree with you.
You don't think that the president said to separate kids from families?
I don't think the president wants to separate anyone, especially parents and their kids. No, they
don't.
But
he did exactly that with his zero tolerance policy. That's how we got in this mess, Antonio. You must know that as a matter of fact.
Well, no, we follow the law. But he didn't make the law, did he?
Right, you follow the law.
Did he write the law? So he's following the law. Like, if I break the law, I have to pay consequences like you and I and everybody else in this country that is legally here.
But how you enforce the law matters, right? Not everybody who...
Well, that's what we
got
to do. We have to. The immigration situation, we know it, you know it, and I know it, has been broken for a long time. So we have to start fresh, and we have to start talking and making sure that we get a good one in place coming up soon, hopefully after November.
Now, one of the reasons that I wanted you to come on tonight, and as your race goes on, you are welcome to come back, and I'll tell you why. I don't think it helps you in your race. It helps me with my reporting. It helps anybody watching this show. If it's always about hostility. If I had hostility towards you, Antonio, you wouldn't have been on the show, right? I decide who comes on and who doesn't.
Absolutely not. So I think it's about love, actually. It's about God, it's about love, it's about taking care of people, but also it's about standing firm to the policies that we have and the laws and the constitution of this country.
That's
what I'm saying.
You can argue your policy, you can argue your faith, but you don't have to attack people for asking the questions. You don't have to attack things that you don't like by insult. You can just make
arguments.
Are you
talking to yourself right now?
I'm talking to you.
Like you should be talking.
I'm talking to you.
I think you're talking to yourself.
No, I'm not talking to myself.
Because you guys do that very well.
If I'm talking
you're
to myself, then I need some kind
day.
Of different medication. I'm trying to get a point through you.
I'm not on that medication, brother.
Well, no, I'm
drinking
some
good old-fashioned
water. I would need
water.
Medication. Don't be so jumpy. What I'm saying is we need to be able to have more conversations where instead of attacking me for asking the questions, you answer them, I test them, we go back and forth. People know your ideas. They can make a more informed judgment. That's what I'm out for. If you're into that, you're always welcome back here.
I'm always into that. Absolutely. 100%.
But you got to know it's coming from a good place. People need information and they need less hostility. You agree on that?
Yeah, of course I agree. And hopefully you can take that to the bank yourself and keep it right here, close to your heart.
I try every damn night. I'll have you back soon. Thank you for being on the show.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Antonio Sabato Jr. running for Congress in California. All right. Now, we have a very different perspective. Democratic Congresswoman Debbie Wasserman Schultz of Florida. Just hours ago, she went to one of these facilities where we can't get in. They do not want the media to be your